Welcome, salutations and greetings, everybody. This is Tantalus, and today we're going to play some Overwatch. We're playing in Ilios. Alright. This is the Early Access Beta. Only have it for a few days until the game comes out on the 24th. The beta stops, I think, on the 9th. So, make some videos while we can. I like Ilios map a lot. For those of you who have never played Overwatch, I really recommend trying 76 to learn the maps and stuff. We're on attack, so I'm going to play Pharah. Pharah is a great attack player to start out with. If you've never jumped into Overwatch, one of my favorite characters, period. Thermal spray. Who we got? Got May, McCree, and here we roll. This is a control point game. You basically have one center control point, and the teams try to hold it as long as possible, kind of like capture the flag. I like Pharah. She's got a lot of mobility. One thing to note on Pharah is that her rockets do harm her as well. Fell in a hole. Your explosions will not hurt your teammates, they will hurt you if you hit a wall in front of you or something. So, something to keep in mind while you play Pharah. Her basic ability is that rocket shot. A little bit of lag there, it looks like, for her. Whoa, almost fell in a hole again. She's got a knockback rocket and, of course, her jump. Looks like they're not being too aggressive. Enemy, oh, coming in from the side. We got May and a Mercy running initial defense. Yeah, baby. I'm basically just firing my rockets in that room as a form of, ooh, Widowmaker top. I didn't even see her up there. Her rockets are really good zone control. So even if there's no enemies in the room, you can kind of keep them from coming in the room by a steady barrage of rockets. We seem to be taking this pretty uncontested, though. I want to get on that point. I don't know why my teammates aren't taking out that Widowmaker. They seem to be focused on the main avenues of approach, and Widowmaker's kind of uncontested. One thing to note in Pharah, it's not the best idea to try to get a direct hit with the rockets. You want to aim at their feet or their, like at the angle I was, the ceiling above them. Hanzo ultimate. Or at the walls around them to kind of deny them. They got two Reapers going on their team. Two Reapers, Pharah, Widowmaker, Mercy, Winston. We almost got the point though, 99%. If we can make one good strong push, we got this. Heroes never die. see if I can sneak on to the point over here. Hit my ultimate and try to clear Winston out. Hopefully make some room for my teammates to get in there. Two Reapers though on a control point is hard to get in there. May needs an ult in that thing. Reason Reaper's so good on a control point is because it's always close range, and Reaper's amazing close range. Probably the best close range fighter other than maybe May. Get out of the Reaper ult. Just trying to hold on here a little bit longer. Get out. Just trying to keep my distance until Winston's shield comes down. We need to get on this point fast though. Cannot believe. I don't know why I seem to be the only one on the control point. It's kind of annoying. Gotta get on that point fast. Get on it, get on it, get on it. Told my teammate. Tell my teammate they need to be on the point. Remember your training, and we'll get through this just fine. I normally don't like playing frontline on this. I love playing backline characters and just making opportunities happen for teammates. Somebody's stuck here. Somebody. Switch my strategy up. Let's switch heroes. Let's go with 76. 76 is a phenomenal hero to learn Overwatch on, especially if you're not really familiar with maps yet. 76 is a great offensive character. He's got defensive and support capabilities, though, as well. He's got his heal that is really, really nice to throw down for your teammates. Besides, who doesn't want to all be a soldier? Alright, seem to have a lull in the fighting a little bit. Ah, you gotta be kidding. I thought I fell off the ledge there for a second. Just kind of wanting to put suppressive fire out there right now. preemptive heal down in case I take some damage. Where's that Widowmaker? I know she's up there somewhere. So we got Zarya, Mercy, and 2 76s. That's really good. We got a lot of sustain then. Junkrat. Did that Widowmaker come in with her machine gun? That's odd. Plus 76 has a sprint, so if you don't have like a Lucio or a Symmetra, he's really good for getting back to the points very quickly. We need to get on this though. Alright, got my ult ready. Good. Team did a lot better that time of staying on the objective. Sometimes people forget that this is, who we got on or something. Alright, I'm gonna switch. I wanna provide a little bit of backline for these guys. I love Hanzo. I love the Hanzo, Widowmaker, McCree's that can stay back a little bit and make moments happen. I was trying to fly up there as a Pharah for a second. Where am I getting? Dagnabbit. He just kind of had his way with me. I didn't even pay attention to the fact that I was getting hit. Hanzo's are a sonic arrow that kind of is like a mini version of Widowmaker's ult, where it allows you to see the enemy silhouettes through walls and stuff. And his secondary ability is a bouncing shot. And he can climb, which is awesome. I was trying to ignore the Winston. He's playing a good Winston. He's making it so that we can't ignore him. Let's see if I've never tried to get up here. Let's see if I can do it. Yep. Oh, nope. That didn't work. Not the way I wanted it to. I'm gonna go around the side here and try to take out their Widowmaker. Okay. I do have my ult ready though, so I can try to clear the area out once I get in there again. Now, unlike his other abilities, where you can cue the arrow and then shoot it whenever you want, his ultimate has to be fired off when you press the button. So. Got him. Oh, shit. That's not good. Dang it. That was a very unfortunate res. Mercy tried, but I will not be defeated, so what, Alonso? Dang. That Winston did a really good job of intercepting the team before we could get to the point. These control points are like that sometimes, where if you get a good front line going on the opponent's side of the control point, it's really hard to get back in and take it. I'll rate that match pretty good. She did a really good job of trying to keep us up. Yeah, great Winston play by that dude. Really good Winston play. Control point is probably my least favorite type of map objective. I really like escort, or I can't remember what they call it, where you escort the payload maps, like this one, Route 66. I love payload maps, especially on defense. I love playing defense on payload map. I'll probably go with my... Okay, yeah, so I'll go Symmetra. I love Symmetra. She's my favorite character. She's not the... she takes a lot of finesse. She's not like Lucio, where you pretty much can run around and do anything and count on healing. And I suck as far as remembering to put shields on my team, which some would say was her primary point. But her turrets, I play her a lot like a Torbjorn, where I'm relying on her turrets to do most of the work. She has really good zone control too. So her shift ability is the ability to put a turret down, these little laser beam turrets. Her E ability is to put a small shield on a teammate. And then she has a secondary fire, which I love. Like that. Let's just warn them before they even start. Her attacks also go through shields like Reinhardt's, so they're phenomenal counters to like a Reinhardt or a Winston or a Zarya. And her ultimate is phenomenal on attack or defense. It's a teleporter, so allowing your team to get to the objective faster no matter what role it is, whether you're attacking or defending, is priceless. It's so vital to have if you want to keep pressure on an objective. So the key with her turrets, I've found, is not putting them where they will hit enemies now. So you don't want to rush into the battle and throw your turrets up. You want to anticipate the path the enemy team is going to take and throw your turrets down as they do it. So bam, teleporter and oh. Oh, I'm still alive. Holy crap. That was unexpected. So again, another zone controlling type of hero. Put that there to bug them as they come in. Ooh, Widowmaker, ding. Good counter. Symmetra has a really low health pool, but most of it is shields, which do recharge after a while. which is useful. So she can be a bit more tanky than people think. If she doesn't die in the initial barrage, she has a good chance of surviving for a while. I'm going to lay some preemptive turrets around for when they do eventually get here. Like I said, these big balls of shield-piercing energy are phenomenal zone control. So I'm just kind of dissuading them from coming in here. You want to try to put the turrets in just random spots where they won't expect them to be, or where they will be so concerned with hitting your teammates that the turrets just have free reign to kind of wreck them. They don't do a ton of damage, but it can build up over time. Eat that, Widowmaker. See, like, that Tracer's too concerned with me, so she doesn't have the time to take out the turret. That there for when she eventually comes back out. Here's one of my I don't have it yet. There we go. This is one of my favorite spots for one of those. One thing to mention is Winstons are really good at clearing out your turrets. So if you're against a Winston, you'll lose turrets right and left. She's starting to clear these out more. So she did a really good job of clearing out the turrets. Of course, a couple of those turrets were placed in positions that weren't ideal. Places that are easily seen or countered. Because the game's new, a lot of Reinhardts and Winstons don't realize that that your attacks do go through the shield, so it can be useful. Ooh. Thank you, Torbjorn. And we win. Yeah, see your turrets as harassment, and try to place them in places where, on the reverse part of a chokehold, so that while they're fighting your opponents, your turrets are just eating away at them. And that gets your ultimate charged, like, really stupid fast. His turret did some work, too. If you have, on defense, a, got 16 turret kills. That's pretty good. If you have a Torbjorn or Bastion and a Symmetra all on defense, it is so hard to take a choke point. So on there, we saw how they got to that checkpoint, but once they got there, into that narrow corridor, they had a real hard time taking our defensive position down. In large part due to that Torbjorn, the fact that the Symmetra and the Reaper were keeping them from attacking us. On attack, on this map, I'm gonna go... no, Widowmaker. Or Hanzo, because we have a Widowmaker. Redemption. No tank heroes. Alright, let me go tank them. We don't have a support hero. Utility. Okay. On this map, in the beginning, I would not have picked Symmetra. And that's one thing that people should keep in mind when they're playing Overwatch. Switch characters often. I did non-Symmetra because Symmetra is just so strong a defensive hero. But typically, you want to fit what part of the map you're on, what your comp is, by switching characters constantly. So like in this, because we have to get to that first before we start moving forward, and we don't have a support, I would have gone with a Lucio first, because he provides mass healing, instead of a Symmetra. Once we get the payload farther down, Symmetras are awesome, because they can put that teleporter up. But in the beginning, initial moments, I wouldn't recommend a Symmetra. I don't have a spray on this guy. That sucks. Oh, that's a cool spray. That looked like a achievement spray. So my job right now is just to provide a wall for them to move behind. And a Roadhog behind me. It's hard as Reinhardt because you have to provide that wall as you move forward. And if your teammates aren't doing a great job clearing people out as you move forward, you can get stuck like that where... you have enemies behind you. So I'm going to attempt to move forward again. Wow, they're taking that shield down quick. I'm not too good on tank characters, if you haven't noticed. Alright, so I'm going to move forward and hope my teammates follow me. Not a whole lot I could have done there. Rest of my teammates seem to be dead. Not much I could do there. That sucked. Tried to boost forward there. Where's the crap is behind me? Yeah, I'm just trying to be a mobile platform that they can fight behind. Ah, those Winstons are annoying. So tried to do some damage, but I had no follow-up damage there. They were stunned. I just couldn't get anybody else to hit on them. Oh, that's a dangerous teleporter position. Need to clear that teleporter off that. I mean, not clear the teleporter off there. Clear the turret on it. Ooh, nope, 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 nope. Bad. Bad. As soon as I hit it, I knew that was bad. I tried canceling out of it. I couldn't. That sucks. What I think people were happening there. And I see this a lot sometimes in Overwatch, especially with newer players come in. People get into the battle mode, the deathmatch mentality, and they stop thinking about what will strategically. She did a really good job, but I gotta give it to this dude. People stop thinking strategically about how to move an objective forward. And they will get into this mentality of trying to get as many kills as possible when you don't need to necessarily get kills. You need to move the objective forward. Push them back. Zone them out. Not necessarily killing them. Killing them is great because it gives you some downtime. But for a team comp like they had, where they had Torbjorn just completely shutting down an entire area, Winston getting into us and disrupting our team, they needed to focus more on zone control. It's really hard to do. I could have probably done more to tell them that. We have a Symmetra. Let me go Bastion. I love Bastion. If you're looking for a defensive hero, by the way, that's really easy to play. 76 is pretty defensive. He can be. Bastion's really easy to play. I like Bastion because he's complete zone control. And really, what makes good Bastion players, what separates good Bastion players from decent Bastion players is positioning. Knowing where to position so that you aren't countered easily. try to find a position where I can see all approaches to me. So here, pretty much the only way they can get around to me is to loop around and come from behind. Meanwhile, I can just kind of unload on them. That tracer could probably be annoying in a little bit. See if we can zone her out. Yep. Tracer, the bane of all bastions. Because she can just zip behind you before you get a chance to take her down. And honestly, that Winston was more of a danger to the team than the Tracer was, so I was trying to focus him down as much as I could. Well, they got on that point fast. It is. Okay, so now we need to find a position where we can hold and try to do the most damage. I like high places. I like places I can't be countered easily from. That was not good. I was expecting us to have more of a front line there. Not sure what my teammates are doing. I don't want to know why we don't seem to have a front line at all. It's because we don't have a front line at all. But we also don't have a whole lot of defensive builders, so I'm going to have to stay on Bastion. That was bad. That was really bad. Thank you. Yep.
All right.
I'm leaving this team. That's the third straight loss we've had because people are just stuck in a deathmatch mentality. Devereaux side. That's a pretty cool one. I've got you in my sights. Oh, I can do this like when I've lost. Alright, let's try something else. Let's try to get into a different team. Or a different game. If I'll go switch to Widowmaker, and that was towards the end of the game, when they're right on our spawn point. Okay, something about Overwatch. You should not play the character you like to play most. Just like Heroes of the Storm in Hero League, you should have at least two characters in every role that you're comfortable with. Two supports, two defensive players, two offensive players, two tanks that you're pretty comfortable with, and be able to switch based on what the team needs. For instance, I'm assuming Falco switched to Widowmaker because he loves Widowmaker and he's a really good Widowmaker player. That may be true, but for instance, if that happened while in that last section, while they're right on us, almost about to end, that's not a great play, because he may be a phenomenal Widowmaker player, but Widowmaker in that instance is not particularly useful. Whereas if we had two Reinhardts, or Reinhardt Winston, or Reinhardt Roadhog, we had a Mei, which was really good. If he had stuck with McCree, McCree can do a lot of damage in medium to close range. A Reaper would have been good. Pharah for zone control. That kind of stuff means more in Overwatch than being able to play one character really, really well. So that's something to keep in mind. Always adjust your hero selection, your play style to fit. And I could have probably switched off Bastion a lot earlier than I did, but we didn't have a whole lot of defensive characters. Alright, looks like I'm playing Reinhardt. Let's go with Roadhog. I'm not a great tank player, but we'll see how this goes. Okay, a little bit on Roadhog. He's got the hook. If you've played Heroes of the Storm, it's like Stitches. If you've played League of Legends, it's like Blitzcrank. Pulls you to them. He's got his primary fire, which is like a shotgun blast. His secondary fire is like a delayed shotgun blast. Throws the ball out and explodes. And his E heals him. Gives him a quick heal. He's just a big meat factory. Walking around. Whoa. Okay. Where the crap is my team? Seriously. I had Mercy on me. Not too afraid of that Reaper as long as he stays at range. Is that us or them? Can't do anything.
Oh.
Okay, so we are 5v6. Nope, 5v5. So instead of going for the one else can do for us attack. That could not be more appropriate. See, they're all up in that room trying to fight up there instead of on the point. Stupid. And, yep. Deathmatch mentality. It's great if you have a couple people in front of the objective or off to the side trying to do zone control. But that only works if you have people on the point. Okay, we got a Reinhardt this time, and a Reaper. Hopefully this team learns from the mistakes we made the first time. My hooks are not landing. Alright, see, so we got a good, strong front line on this point. Got some people that can move around. Good res, good res. Trying to clear the area, make sure it hurts them to come in here. Got a Winston on the point. Couldn't hold it. Help if I was laying in more hooks. I'm not sure what he's shooting at. I got my ult up though. So if I can get there and get some support, I can do some damage really quickly. They're at 39%. Alright, let's do the whole hog. Mm-hmm. and stuck. At least we got some people on the point, though. This Tracer player is really good. She's been bugging the crap out of me. Good, 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 good. Now if we can just finish this off, we'll be set. I'm going to come around this side. They've always seen me come around the other side more times. See if I can come through here and do some damage. Nope. Widowmaker. That's a really good Widowmaker slot. She timed that really well. Looks like we got this one, though. Maybe not. Let's get on it. Let's get on this. Yeah, that's a hook. Get on the point. Genji play. She had some good reses. I'll give it to her. That could have been a lot higher. What are you gonna do though? Temple of Anubis. This is a control point game, but it is one where you take a control point and then you move forward. And you move forward between rounds. So it's not like the one we just did. You take the first defensive point, and then you have to take a second point, and then it's over. And you have a certain amount of time to do that. So yeah, here's a good example. Alright, we got Roadhog and a Winston. Got 76. Reaper and Zenyatta. If you're a new player to Overwatch, do not play Zenyatta. It's really, really hard. I think that D.Va stayed a little too long. A little more than she wanted to. Got me before I got him. Reaper's on the point. Yeah, I knew I was going to probably die there, but I wanted to take out as much of their front line as possible. We got first control point. Try to come around here to the side. Took out the turret, and I think I forced Sebastian back. I don't think I killed him. Hopefully it clears the way for some of my teammates to get on that point. Like Reaper, I'm not too concerned with D.Va being at distance. She doesn't do a whole lot of damage. That Widowmaker keeps not wanting me to do justice. She's all about injustice. Sometimes what I'll do on Pharah is come in from a flank and try to pull two or three teammates of theirs over to me to deal with me so that my teammates can come in the main way. Doesn't look like that happened. They're all stuck in trying to get through that one choke point. We need to clear that bastion out. We're just charging out of bats and no one's doing anything about it. Like, me and that tank guy are trying to do as much as we can, but no one else is doing anything. I hate to be the guy that blames his teammates, but seriously. Finally. Yeah. That was either her or the Bastion. Bad. That's decent. That's okay. That could have been better. That definitely could have been better. Alright, well, that's it for today. Thank you. Good luck. Have fun.